It's the end of the season, and we're getting ready for our final miticide treatments, our cleanup treatment, oxalic acid. I'm going to be showing you in this video two different methods that we use to deliver oxalic acid during the broodless periods. Remember that OA is only to be used during broodless periods, which is either the beginning of the season or the end of the season after brood comes off. So that's when we're going to properly use this. I'm going to show you the two methods, vaporization and dribble method, in this instructional video. So this is a hive that we're getting ready to go into winter. It's October here in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. This is typically when our brood season ends. And the genetics in this particular apiary are New World Carnolians, and they're specifically bred for winter climates. And one of the nice traits that they carry with them is the ability to shut down early. So they respond really well to early season signals that winter's coming and brood ceases early in the season. So this colony right here is completely broodless at this point. This is a two-story colony. You see we've got a deep and a medium on here. These are completely backfilled with nectar and honey. And so what we're going to do at this point is we're going to deliver an OA application. Now keep in mind, when you're doing oxalic acid, the dribble method, in my opinion, is the preferred method because it's the safer method for you. You don't have to wear a respirator. You're not at risk of harming your lungs. You just have to make sure that you're wearing chemical gloves and that you're being safe about it. Glasses or goggles as well. But the big thing with about the dribble application is that you have to do it when temperatures allow you to. Sometimes up here in northern Michigan, we may hit the broodless period at the same time that we're starting to hit the snow period. And if that happens, the vaporization method is a very good method because you can use it down to very cold temperatures and it's an immediate delivery. With this, you want to make sure that your daytime temps are still some, I like to see somewhere around in the low 60s, high 50s. Today, it's about 62 outside. It's nice and sunny. The bees are not flying a whole lot. Most of them are in this colony, which is what you want at this point because you want everybody here as you're delivering this chemical. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to open this up. And with the dribble method that I'm going to show you right now, what we're going to do is we're going to force all of these bees down into one box. We're trying to get all of our bees down into one area so that we can deliver this method on those bees in a single box. So I'm going to open this up first. See a nice full box of bees here. This is a great looking colony going into winter. Again, it's totally packed full of resources. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my smoker and I'm going to smoke these bees down. Now, you know from watching my videos that I don't tend to use a smoker a whole lot. When you want to direct your bees to do something, like consolidate into a single box, you're going to have to force them to do that. And you do that with a smoker. So you see that a lot of this area has cleared on the top. The bees are pushing down at this point. And so what I'm going to do while they're still pushing down is I'm going to come down here and I'm going to pop this bottom box. You can see my got a few frames stuck here. All right. We're going to take that top box. Oh, and that's a heavy one full of honey. And you can see that we've got a nice section of bees down here. Every seam between these frames is full of bees. And that's what you want in this particular method, because we're going to deliver 5 milliliters of oxalic acid solution. That's a 1-to-1 sugar water solution with oxalic acid added into it. And you're gonna put 5 milliliters of each of that chemical in each one of these seams on this 10 frame equipment. So I've got my mixture here. I'm gonna go ahead, use my turkey baster that has 50 milliliters measured out on it. I'm gonna suck up 50 milliliters. Let's get that all the way up to the top there. There we go. I'm gonna set that aside and I'm gonna just go through each one of the seams and deliver that 5 milliliters. You don't wanna get a bunch on the frames. You want it on the bees. You don't want it on the frames. And so make sure as you're going along that you're staying in those seams. Now the bees are gonna move the oxalic acid crystals around into the colony. So they're doing kind of the work for you that the vaporization does, which is the, you know, the nice thing about it, the vapor method is the coverage. And so the bees are doing the coverage part of this for you by moving this all around in the colony. And there you go. Real simple solution, real easy way to apply, very safe for you, safe for your bees, and very quick. So you can get this done pretty quick. At this point in time, All we're going to do is reassemble our colony. Oh, yeah, that's heavy, heavy box there. Always a good sign. You want those heavy boxes at the end of the season. And then we're going to cap this off. And now this season, we are ready to close this hive down. That's our last. Welcome, everybody. Dr. Adam here today. It may look a little unfamiliar today. I'm all shaved up. We're doing oxalic acid applications today. And the reason I had to shave was because OA vaporization or sublimation, you can get that into your lungs. And it is pretty darn rough on your respiratory system when you're doing these applications. So we end up using a respirator with organic acid rated cartridges on them. And so that's why I'm shaved up. If you are doing OA applications with vaporization, you need to make sure that you are wearing a properly fitting respirator and that you don't have any facial hair on. Those respirators will not seal if you have facial hair. So that's why I've shaved today. It's the only time of the year you'll ever see me shave. But in this video, what I'm gonna show you is I'm gonna show you how we do an OA sublimation, also known as vaporization application. I'm gonna be showing you a piece of equipment that we have, which is the ProVape 110. Now, everything I'm showing you on here today is usable with any of the wands or any other OA vaporization applicator. This one is a little bit more on the expensive side. This is about a $500 applicator. The reason that we use this is because it's a highly efficient applicator. I'm gonna do a time-lapse video for you all on this apiary. We've got, I think, 13 or 14 hives in here. You'll be shocked at how fast this goes. But this is a bit of an investment, and because we're at a larger scale, we needed something to get more efficiency. But if you're in 20, 30, 40 hives, the wands work just fine and many of the other applicators work just fine. But the principles are all going to be the same. So let me show you a few of the things that we have to be conscious of when we set our hives up for these OA applications. Okay, so the first thing that I do when I'm setting up an apiary for OA applications is I take material. This is all torn up t-shirts that you see in this particular hive. I wet them and then I stuff all the openings. So essentially the top entrance and the bottom entrance are stuffed with these wet materials. That helps keep the OA in. With some of the application methods, you're gonna do it through the front entrance. So you will basically, like with the wands, you'll basically pop out your entrance reducer, put the wand in, and then put your wet towels around the wand as you're applying it. For this particular method that I'm using with the ProVape, we actually drill a quarter inch hole in the back of the hive and we apply through the back. And basically it allows us to seal up the fronts and then just go one hive at a time very quickly with this applicator. You can see that I've got all these hives set up with towels and everything, and these as well. And so these are all ready to go. Basically, now I just have to get my applicator here, the piece of equipment that I'm using for applying. I need to get that up to temperature. You can see that this also, compared to some of the other applicators, this uses 110. And so I have a generator that I run this applicator on, and that makes it so that this goes very fast. With the wand applicators and some of the other applicators, you use a car battery. And keep in mind that, you know, the car battery is only get you through so many hives. So this, I don't have to worry about a car battery, you know, for 70 or 80 hives. You know, we can get through them very easily with this. And typically for us, at about, well, 70 or 80 hives, you're going to get through this with this particular applicator. I can usually get this all done in about 2 hours, which is an amazing efficiency when you consider how much time it takes to do some of the other applications. So let's take a look and see how this is done.